Good morning, one and all. A warm welcome to all of you. Second day of introduction to management applications. Yesterday we saw some of the participants are they turn off their videos. Now I request all the participants during the session switch off. Your videos and also mute your microphones. Now I request Satyakumar sir to take the session. Now Satyakumar sir, I'm hand over to you.
Yeah, thank you ma'am, thanks for the invite. So let us start our session. So thanks for SV College of Engineering. So thanks for this opportunity. Thank you Anta ma'am for invite, and let us begin our session with the leftover things of yesterday's session. So let me give you some recap and then let us move on to show you some great applications, what we can do with the MATLAB and kind of things. Hope my voice is clear. Can you please check, Anita ma'am, could you please check, is my voice is clear from my side?
Yes, sir. It's audible, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. Yeah. Thanks for checking with me. So let us begin our session. Thanks for the invite, Anita ma'am. Thanks for the hosting. And let us begin our session. Let me share my screen and then start off the session with some good applications of MATLAB and image processing and many things let us discuss. So let me show you this today. Today, let me show you some great applications, what we can do with the MATLAB. So let us start off the session by sharing my screen. So let me share my screen now. So I'll be sharing, just give me a moment. Yes, I hope my screen is visible to you, I guess. So in yesterday's session, we have discussed about some basic things like the MATLAB desktop window, some basic functions, and how to write a function also. We have discussed at the end of the session yesterday. And then we have discussed about workspace, current folder, and command window, and command history, and editor window, how to create a new M file and how to save it and how to execute it and everything we have discussed, and some control flow statements and conditional statements, many things we have discussed in yesterday's session. So by using all those things, what we can do with the MATLAB and different areas of applications, as I said earlier, so MATLAB have plenty of applications, plenty of areas of applications to have. So let me show you some good applications, application orientation. Like, so we have learned some basics and where you can apply all those things and where you, how you can make some good applications with MATLAB, the different areas like image processing, signal processing, electrical engineering, so, and biology, many things are there. So let me show you some good applications and how to build those applications kind of things I would like to show you this day. So let me show you something interesting thing, how we can do some image processing or how we can do some kind of watermarking. Let me show you some application and then I would like to teach you how to do that application. Let me show you one thing and then let me show you that. Yeah, let me show you one good application and then let me explain you how to design that one. Then you will be familiar. So let me show a good application, which is like, most of you people are aware of watermarking. Most of you people are aware of watermarking, I guess. So let me show you that how we can do watermarking with MATLAB. Let me show you. And then simply we can start off the things doing some interesting things with MATLAB. So let me share my screen. Yeah, I'm going to open a program. Now I would like to show one thing. Yeah, Anita ma'am, no one can write now. I have disabled the participant annotation, no worries. No, no issues, ma'am, I can handle. So let me open some code and let me show you some application and then let me give you some more insights on that. So I'd like to open some good application which you have designed. And then I would like to teach you how to design such kind of applications with the MATLAB. Very interesting, and try to pay your attention. I'm showing some good application. So please follow with my screen. So I'd like to share. We can create some applications like mobile apps we have, right? As like that, we can design some great applications with MATLAB as well. So this is the application which you have designed. So I would like to show you. This is a simply QR code watermarking. I hope you guys know QR codes, right? Quick responsive codes, right? Quick responsive codes. So how to watermark that quick responsive codes kind of things. I would like to show you this decision. So simple application I would like to show you, and I would like to let you know how to design all these kind of things. So let me run the code. This is a simply a GUI, graphical user interface. So I have taken a QR code and I'm going to take some watermark image, some logo. In that logo, I'm going to watermark. I'm going to give some key. This is an example, don't get confused. I'm going to show an application. So simply clicking on watermark. And then this one and this one are watermarked. These two are combined. The finally, this is going to be returned. So let me tell you what I'm going to do here. So let me give you some data on this one. I'm going to embed QR code with watermark image. Simply taking some this one, this image, this is a college logo. I want to transfer this logo, which is a secret information, to a person. So, but if I send as it is, some hackers can hack the data, then they can steal our information. So simply I'm going to embed this data. I'm combining those two information. See here, this is the after embedding. That means after watermarking. In this image, I'm going to combine this image with mathematically and programmatically. I'm writing a code to watermark this one. That means to hide the information, hiding an information. So simply what I did, I watermarked, taken two images and I watermarked. And then this is on transmission side and this on receiver side. Let me show you watermarked image I have taken. And so let us enter some key which I have given and then process. Then this is a output one. So my intention is to let you know, I want to show you that we can design some different kinds of applications with MATLAB. Here the application is watermarking. I'm going to hide my logo, college logo or something in some image with some key, in secret key. I want to send an image to you, but if I send as it is, some hackers can hack the data. So I have taken some reference image. I'm embedding these two images. That means combining those two images. Then finally, I'll get this image. No one can identify this one. Though they can identify without having this key, they cannot access this data. So this is a transmission side and this is a receiver side. Simply taking the watermarked image and giving a key, then we'll get this kind of output. In such a way, simply we can design some very good applications with MATLAB. So image processing applications, signal processing application, mathematical applications, different kinds of things we can do with MATLAB. So let me show, this is a simple example. Let me show you some greatest applications, greatest tools we have in MATLAB, or what are those and how we can design something. So most of you people have soft phones, that means smartphones. Most of you people have smartphones. In our smartphones, we people have some different kinds of applications, right? Different kinds of mobile applications we have. In those mobile applications, we have different kinds of operations and push buttons. Many things are there, right? Hope you people are using smartphones. So let us discuss about how to design some different kinds of applications, apps. In most of the apps or some Google Forms also, even you have been experiencing, there is a submit button. There is a some submit button. On clicking submit, the data is going to be submitted. That means on a back end, some operation is going to be done. On front end, there is a button. As like that, all of your mobile applications have some buttons and something, some drop down menus and all. First, suppose if you click on some button, some operation is going to be done. On clicking some button, some other operation is going to be done. In such a way, there are some different kinds of applications. There are some different kinds of mobile applications we have. As like that, if I want to design some different kinds of applications with MATLAB, we have a tool which is called GUI, Graphical User Interface. We have Graphical User Interface, which is a MATLAB advanced tool to design user interactive applications and as well to get control over execution. First, suppose you have written some 1,000 lines of code. In these 1,000 lines of code, if I want to run only 100 lines of code for an instant, for a single instance, if I want to run code for 100 lines, or if I want to run 100 lines of the code for a single instance, then every time we need to place a breakpoint and a run, breakpoint and a run, this kind of process will be somewhat complex. But when you want to get control over execution and to design user interactive applications, we have a greatest tool that is what Graphical User Interface is, GUI, Graphical User Interface, which is a very good one to design user interactive applications, like as I shown, some watermarking applications I have shown you, right? So in such a way, simply we can create. Let us make you familiar with this one. To make you interesting about this MATLAB, I would like to show you how to design some simple calculator, how to design a simple calculator with MATLAB. I would like to show you how to design a simple calculator with MATLAB. In simple calculator, we are going to give some two inputs A and B. I want to calculate addition, subtraction, multiplication, and as well some division or something, and then the results. This kind of simple calculator we can design by using MATLAB. Let me show you how to design this kind of simple calculator using Graphical User Interface, which is advanced tool to create user interactive applications and to get control over execution. Let me show you that. So let me show you that one. So to create Graphical User Interface, to create GUI applications, first one, go to command window. This is the command window we people know. This is the command window. The first one we need to go for command window. In command window, type a command GUIDE. Type a command GUIDE and press enter button. Type a command GUIDE and press enter. So let us see what happens. Type a command GUIDE and press enter. When you press and enter, you will have an option. When you press and enter, you will have a dialog box. GUI Quick Start dialog box will be there. When you click on GUIDE and enter, then there are two options. And this one, GUI Quick Start window. In this GUI Quick Start window, we have two options like create new GUI, open existing GUI. In this create new GUI, click on blank GUI. Create new GUI, click on blank GUI. Then click on OK button. So create new blank GUI and click on OK. So once you click on OK, wait for a moment, a GUI window will be open for you. A GUI window will be open for you. Oh, let me share my screen. So this is the GUI window will be open. Like this, a GUI window will be open. This is called GUI window. This is called Graphical User Interface window. This is called Graphical User Interface window, GUI, Graphical User Interface. That means to design applications. Like in applications, there will be two design methodologies. One is front-end design. Second one is back-end design, back-end. In front end, we design UI, user interface. In back end, we write code files. And we connect UI to code. So that as like websites and Google Forms or something, some button, some options will be there. Like, so simply like that, we can design some front end, that is UI, user interface, and back end, that is simply this one, code part. So now on this screen, we are going to design our UI, user interface. Now we are going to design user interface. That means how user can interact with the code. This is now we are going to deal with user interface. My intention is to design a simple calculator. Which have four buttons, Four buttons for, one is for addition, one is for subtraction, one is for multiplication, one is for division. And one box one edit box. This is called edit box. One edit box is for input and another box for input and another box for some output. So like this, I want to design some application. I want to design some application, a simple calculator application by using graphical user interface. Let us design this one together. So let me start off the things with GUI. So if anyone have any questions while I'm teaching, you can post your questions in a chat box. So I request you to please switch off your videos. That will be disgusting to others. Yes. So let us start off the things with this GUI. The first button, this is a, hope you guys familiar with MS Paint. We have some different toolboxes, like tools like pen, pencil, some brushes, some shapes, some rectangles, some oval shapes, different kinds of things will be there. So let us simply take a look on this toolbox. This is called toolbox. This is a GUI toolbox. In this one, we have first one is a OK button that is called push button. That is OK button, or simply we can call it as push button. What is a push button? Push button is a process button which performs certain operation on pressing it. Push button is a process button which performs certain operation on pressing it. For suppose in our mobile applications, you have some different buttons. On clicking that button, some operation is going to be done. As like that, here also, we have a OK button that is a push button. So push button is a process button which performs certain operation, on pressing it. Right. So let us take how many buttons we need. For our calculator, we need 4 buttons. Let us take one button, click on that. Then this kind of mouse pointer will be there. Then hold the mouse left key, hold and drag like this. Then we'll have a push button simply like this. Then if I want to change some names and customization, that is also we can do. I want to name this push button as addition. I want to name that push button as addition, and the button color something blue, and this push button text color some yellow, and font size 10, and font weight bold. I want to make some changes. I want to write this push button name in yellow color, and push button color something blue, and push button name addition, and push button text size, this push button text size 10. I want to make the text in a bold. These kind of properties I want to change. Then if I want to change some properties, simply double click on that push button. Once you double click on it, you will be open. Inspector window will be open. Here, there are many property options will be there. But the first one is background color, which I want to make it as blue. Some background color will be there. Here you can click on this one. You can change the color. And font size here, I want to change the font size. Here I can change something like some 10, 12, or based on your interest. And font weight, bold I want to take. Simply you can select bold option here. And foreground color, the text color I want to make it as some yellow, something yellow. I can simply click on this one, I can select. And the important thing is, if I want to change the push button name, that is string, go to string and give a name here. So let us make all the required changes. let us make all the required changes. Go to string and change name as addition. I'm going to change as addition, and I want to make this color as some yellow. Click on that one and select yellow color. And font size, I want to make it as some 10 or something. And font angle, some italic or bold or something I can take. And push button color, I want to make it as something blue. Then after making and font weight, I want to make it as bold. So after making some changes, after making all the property changes, simply you can close it. So once you close it, this kind of window will be open, so that we have changed the properties of a button. Simply, we have changed the properties of a button. That means blue color background, yellow color, and some bold, different kinds of properties we have changed. How many buttons we required for our calculator? Let us take 3 more buttons. Simply copy it, copy, on right click, copy, and paste here. How many buttons we need? 4 buttons we need. Like these 4 buttons, rather we can change the heading. That means push button name we can change later. So let us take this one. We can adjust based on your interest only, no problem. And you can expand or you can reduce the size of your area of a GUI based on this drag. You can hold here and you can drag. So these are the 4 buttons. This is for subtraction. If I want to change the name, simply double click on that. Once you double click on that, you will be open in inspector window. Simply go to string. Simply change name as subtraction. And enter and close it. And then simply the value will be changed here, subtraction. And I want to change addition. This one, third one also I want to change as multiplication. Simply double click on that. Then inspector window will be open. In that inspector window, go to string, change as multiplication. So in such a way, simply you can change the name and you can simply close it. So once you close it, this kind of window will be opened for you. And then simply click on other one also, double click on that. Then inspector window will be opened. Go to string and change as simply like division. So based on your interest, you can make some changes to your GUI. So once after making all changes, simply your 4 push buttons will be displayed like this. Your 4 push buttons will be displayed like this. Now, once you click on this button, the addition operation has to be done. On clicking subtraction operation has to be done. On clicking multiplication operation has to be done. On clicking division operation has to be done. So for that one, we need to take some 2 inputs. To take inputs, we have a edit box. The second, third one is from a first column, the third one is an edit box. Simply click on edit and paste here. Simply paste here. Like this. This is an edit box. Here you can enter your values. So that on that value operation is going to be done. These were input 1 and we need 1 more. So simply double click on that. If you want to change the properties, double click on that. Once you double click on that, simply inspector window will be opened. Go to string and remove it edit text. Remove this one. Remove this edit text and change the font size as something 12 and something as bold. That's all. You can simply change your properties and close it. Then this kind of edit box window will be opened. So we need 1 more edit box. Simply copy it and paste here. Here, 2 buttons, 2 edit boxes to take inputs. 2 edit boxes to take inputs. And 1 is for taking output. Simply copy and paste. This is 3. This I would like to show you. This is a edit box one. This is called edit box one. This is called edit box two. And this is called edit box three. And this is called push button one. This is push button two. And this is push button three. And this is push button four. So we need to write the code for all these edit one, edit two, edit three, edit four. Now we are done with taking all the required design of our UI. Now user interface is now ready. User interface is now ready. So for this one, I want to give some title. I want to give some title for this. So for giving a title, simply click on text, TXT. Here you can see my cursor, TXT is there. Simply click on the TXT and place wherever you want, simply like this. Place it here and double click on that. Then inspector window will be opened. Go to string and give you a title. Simply I'm writing my calculator. I'm giving some name and I want to give some color. I want to give some font size as well, some 16 or something, and bold. I want to give some color as something blue or something, some green. You can give any and close it. And then once you close it, your window will be like this. We have given some title also. If I want to change the background color, simply double click on the background. And then simply inspector window will be opened. From this inspector window, color you can change. Simply give a color and close it. And then this kind of window will be open. So that background color we have taken. So calculator heading, two inputs here and output here, four buttons. Now, once you are done with the designing of your GUI, that means the front end. Once you are done with designing of your front end GUI, then simply save it. Control S. No need to do anything. Simply save it. I'm going to save on my desktop. No need to give any extension. Simply give your name. Then automatically, once after saving, MATLAB automatically generates a code for you. See here, this is the code automatically generated for your GUI. Once after saving, this is a skeleton. This is a skeleton for your GUI. That is a front end design. Now we need to write the code in back end. So created at 7th June 2020, 11 a.m., 11:28 a.m. in the morning, right? So now this is created. So once after saving, automatically a skeleton or GUI code will be automatically generated. Auto-generated MATLAB code for your GUI. So how many push buttons you have taken? Four push buttons you have taken. This is the code for push button one, code for push button two, push button three, and as well push button four. So what it means basically, on clicking push button one addition, some addition operation has to be done, and that code for addition operation code we need to write here. For subtraction, we need to write the code here. For multiplication, for division, we need to write the code here for our push buttons. These push buttons are different functions. Function one, function two, push button one callback, push button two callback, push button three callback, push button four callback, and so on. So let us write the code for that. Now I want to write the code for push button one. Then come down to here, push button one. So in my GUI, I have two edit boxes. Edit one, and this is edit two, and we have four push buttons. And this is edit three. This is addition and subtraction, multiplication, division. This is my GUI. For this GUI, I want to write the code here. Now, I want to write the code here for push button one. So the two inputs. Now, my intention is to design a calculator which takes two inputs A and B, which shows output C. If I give A and B here, if I give A, if I give B here, if I click on addition, then addition result should be here. If I click on subtraction, subtraction result should be here. If I click on multiplication, the multiplication result should be here. So let us take some two variables. Let us take some A variable A equal to, I want to get the value. I want to get the value from edit box one. So let us get the value. Get is a function to get the value from edit box. Get of handles dot from where I want to take edit box one. What kind of data it will be? It will be string type of data. In edit boxes, it strings only supported. So what I am writing here, let me explain you. I am writing a function get. Get is to get the value from edit box. Which edit box? Edit box one. This is edit box one. Handles means referencing. Referencing means connecting our front end GUI to back end code. And then in edit boxes, whatever we enter in the edit box, that will be in always string format. So I am writing A equal to get of handles, the reference variable, handles dot edit one. That means from a edit box one, I am going to take a string. So whatever we enter there, that will be returned in a string format into a variable A. Now we got a variable A, which is in string format. That is not a number now. So let us continue. So now I want to take B also. B from edit box two. B equal to get of handles dot edit box two. From edit box two, I want to take from edit two, comma, what kind of data I'm going to take? String type of data I'm going to take. So A and B, those are two strings which are taken. Those are two strings taken from edit box one and edit box two. So to perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, A and B should be numbers. But here, A and B are some strings. A and B are some strings taken from edit box one, edit box two. Now I want to convert my A and B, as these are strings, I want to convert into numbers. Let us convert into numbers. Let me write the code for that. So let us take same variable A equal to string to number, str number two to num. String to num is a function which converts your strings into numbers, string to num. And again, B equal to str string to num, string to num of B, string to num of B, string to num of A, string to num of B. That means converting string data into number data. Then A and B are now numbers. So after that, I'm going to perform an operation C equal to A plus B. So addition operation for push button one. This is a push button one. I'm writing that one. Then I want to set here, addition is done. Here simply converted my strings into numbers and addition is done. And now I want to set that C value. In edit box three. I want to set this value in edit box three. Now how we can set? I want to set my values into edit box three. So use a function set of handles dot in which box? Edit box three, comma. What kind of data we are going to display? Only string type of data. String. The data is, but our C is in number. But we can only show strings only. Then number to string, num to string, number to str of what? C. I want to display that. number to string I am using. Simply what I am writing, string type data, I'm going to display in 8box3, num to string of C. C will be converted into string and then will be displayed in 8box3. Let us run the program and check whether it is working or not. Let us run the program and let us check whether it is working or not so that you can get an idea. So click on the run button. Once you are done with the push button one, let us run the program. Once you click on the run button, this kind of GUI window will be opened for you. This kind of GUI window will be opened for you. Very nice, right? So simply enter the values. Some 56 I have entered, some 47 I have entered. Click on addition. Then automatically output will be displayed here. Simply take some other value, some 58, and click on addition. Then addition operation is going to be done. Click on this one. Hope you can see. Hope you can enjoy this one. This is a very good one. Simply in such a way, we can create an application with respect, irrespective of the code, what is running behind. Simply the user can use this user interface. This is how the mobile applications and computer application, web applications, many things are going to be developed. Right, so let us write the code for subtraction, multiplication, and division as well. So let us write, let us complete the code for that one also. Let us write the code for that one also. So let me share the screen. So simply I'm copying it, copying the same code. And pasting over here, copying the same code and pasting over here, and same code, pasting over here, and same code, and pasting over here. And but in second push button, what I want to do? Subtraction, I want to do. Simply make minus symbol. And third one, multiplication, asterisk symbol. And the fourth one, division. Simply you can place division symbol. That's all. I am done with the code now. So let us run this code, let us run the program and check whether it is working perfectly or not. Click the run button, click on the run button, then GUI will be opened for you. Click on the run button, GUI will be opened for you. Give some numbers here, I'm 45, I have given some 34. And click on addition, the output is 45, 34, 79. Subtraction, that is 11. Multiplication, 1530. Division, so 45 by 34. Which returns 1.3235. In such a way, by using Matlab, we can create some very great applications. We can create some very great applications. So it's in such a way, simply you can create. So that is a great advantage to create some great applications for image processing, mathematical applications, and many things. For signal generators also we can do. So let us create some GUI for signal generator. Let us create some GUI for signal generator. Hope this is clear for you. So let me take some questions on this. If you have any questions, you can post. Suresh Kumar sir, direct number is possible, not through 8box. You can post some questions if you have. I am happy to help you. You can post some questions. So, Darshini ma'am, the thing is, the C is number, but in edit box, we can only display strings only. That is why I'm converting number to string. So yes, we can change the function name as well. Handles means reference variable, which connects your front end to back end. Scientific operations also we can do, Rahul sir. Yeah. Yes, all the science applications, anything we can do with GUI, anything. Signal generation, science, econometrics, and mechatronics, and differential equations, and scientific calculations, cos and sine, algebraic equations, and differentiations, integrations, we can do. Differentiation and integration as well. So calculus, entire calculus I can do, Prasanna. Yes. Roots of in calculator, roots of a simple number we can do. Yes. In mobile, it is not supportable. No. Tanuja, no. Yes. In the same way, mobile application also will be created and code will be dumped into cloud. That's all. Set is to set, get is to get the value from that one, but you want to set the value C in 8-box 3, but you want to get the values from 8-box 1, 8-box 2. Even jet transform, Laplacian transform, anything can be Josnam. Yes. Yes, let me talk to you. Yeah. Yes. I'm taking some questions and I'm trying to answer. So someone asking me, yes. So Suresh Kumar sir, let me show you practically. Let me show you some practically. Let me show you some practically so that you can understand. Yes. So in number also we can take, and that is also possible for your understanding. Just I have mentioned here and you can check now. So number also you can take directly and no need to use these two again. Right? Simply you can run the program. See here, like this. Yes. So any other questions? Any other questions, please? Yeah, someone asking me divisible by zero. If I give something divisible by zero, and see, can by numbers also, by taking simply numbers also, we can, that operation is going to be done. First, suppose if I give something zero, and if I go for division, infinity. See here, INF. Someone asked me, Kamala Mama, someone asked me. Yes, can more 8 boxes can be given on inputs? Yes, we can give. Suresh sir, number is possible. Multiple functions in a single syntax, that is possible. Yes, we can take. By using an input function, we can take. Yeah, we can use input to take the data from command window. That's all. Yeah, we can keep some background image for our calculator also. In such a way, some different kinds of things will be done. Let me show you how to do this again. So most of the people asking me how to run this and all. So once after creating your GUI, let me show you that. Once after creating a GUI like this, once after creating a GUI or your front end like this, once after creating like this, simply you can save it. After saving, don't do anything. MATLAB automatically generates a code for you and editor window will be opened automatically. Editor window automatically can be opened without any hassle. Then in this one, how many push buttons you have taken, and that many push buttons will be displayed here. Unedit boxes, push buttons, everything will be displayed here. So in that push button, we need to write the code. For push button one, what is the code we need to write? And push button two, what is you are going to write? Push button three, what you are going to write? These kind of things will get happen this one. So that's all with this. So let us create some GUI for signal generation. Let us create some GUI for signal generation. Let us create some GUI for signal generation. Let me share my screen. the GUI window. Hope it is clear. If you have any questions, you can ask me post my session. If you have any questions, you can ask me post my session. So let us. Let me share my screen now. So Yeah, we can reduce the syntax. Within two lines also we can write. Yeah. Yes, we can. So I'm stopping disabling this. Yes, Manu Rakash, that is done. Yeah. No. So for time being, I'm not getting into the detail of that one. If you have any queries, you can ask me. We can discuss later. So let me show you some other one. Let us discuss how to open this GUI window and all. So let me share the screen. So simply go to the command window. Go to command window, type a command GUIDE. Type a command GUIDE. And then GUI quick start window will be open. GUI quick start window will be open. If any people have a questions, you can ask me. Anita ma'am, I'm enabling chat now. Okay, those who are raising your hands, you can ask me now in chat box. I'm here to help you.
Okay, sir.
So anyone, please. I'm happy to take your questions. Yeah, you can ask questions. You can download. No limit for 8 boxes. Directly you can download from websites. Chauhan ji, what is the meaning for? What is the meaning of another template? I didn't get your point, or you can elaborate your question. Platform name is MATLAB software. This is Devi Prasad. Devi Sri Prasad. Yes. We can optimize the code as well. We can write within 2 or 3 lines. We can do probability and statistics with MATLAB. There is a statistical toolbox also there, dedicated toolbox in MATLAB. Yes, mean, median, we can do. It can support strings and as well, it can support numbers as well. Yeah, MATLAB online is there, you can check. Chinaraza, yes. There is a mobile application, but all these will not be supported. Yes, we can get negative numbers if you subtract from a lesser number. No, does MATLAB will not support online support GUI? No. Yes, we can find the roots of higher order equation. So many applications we have, many other different kinds of applications we have, many more applications, what not, anything, any science, I'd say, any science you can teach with MATLAB, we can do with MATLAB. Yes. So I'm stopping the chat and I'm going to start off the things with how to load some file, how to load some file into MATLAB. Let us take some image file, how to load and how to perform some operation. So simply go to the command window and click on GUI and click on GUIDE. And then a GUI quick start window will be opened. On this GUI quick start window, click on OK. And then a GUI window will be opened. So as I told you in a previous example, simply this is a GUI window. In this one, simply you can take push buttons and some edit boxes to get the inputs. Now Now, my intention is to let you know how to take some files into MATLAB. So I want to take some image file here. I want to take image file. I want to place a button input. On clicking this input button, I want to get some input image here. So output here, I'm writing output some button I want to place. On clicking some output button, I want to get some black and white image or something for my input image, some black and white image that is thing. So let us check this kind of GUI, how we can design, how to take input image file and how we can load that one and how we can convert into others, how we can apply some different kinds of transformations on images and all, I would like to discuss with you. So let us take some two push buttons. The first one I have taken here. So push button one I have taken. I want to edit this one. Double click on that. So change the properties. Double click on that. And then change the properties of that. For time being, all the questions are in depth and have a lot of explanations. But for time being, I'm not taking depth into that. So if you have any questions, you can post my session. So I'm going to make some changes of the properties of my push button. I want to make it as something input. The first button I'm going to take as input. First button I want to take it as input. So close it. So this kind of button will be ready. Now I want to copy this one, copy and pasting here. And two push buttons, one is for input and one is for output. So I want to make it as output. Simple, I'm going to do. So two buttons I have taken. Now I want to show my input image here, output image here. To take images from bottom, the second one. From bottom, the second one, you can see. From the bottom, the second one. From the bottom, the second one. From the bottom, second one, that is called axis. That is called axis. To show images, to show plots as well. To show images and as well to show plots. Click on that and drag here, drop here like this. Drag and drop like this. This is to show images and as well some plots also. Images and as well some plots. Let us take one more. Simply copy it and paste here. So I want to load my input image to this one and I want to get my output image into this one. Once after taking all this, simply save it. Do nothing, simply save it. Simply save it. Once after saving, automatically MATLAB code will be generated. Automatically MATLAB code will be generated. That is called auto-generated skeleton for your GUI. So here, simply on push button one, we need to write the code. On push button one, we need to write the code for loading an image. Loading an image, how to load an image, and loading an image and display it on axis one. Axis one, axis for showing images, axis one. I want to show image in axis one. I want to load an image. Let us write the code for that. So I'm writing some A equal to imread. Imread is a MATLAB function to read images. Imread of some inbuilt image I'm going to take. In MATLAB, we have some different inbuilt images. Peppers.png, I'm going to take some input image. And then I want to show it. Where I want to show? In axis one. For that one, we need to write a function, axis of handles.axis1. In axis one, I want to show my image. So I am show of A. I'm going to show my input image A. Let me explain you this brief. So A is a variable I have taken. Imread is a function to read images. Peppers.png is an inbuilt image in MATLAB image processing toolbox. In MATLAB, we have image processing toolbox. In that, we have some different kinds of input images. So from that input images, I'm going to read some input image that is like some peppers.png. So after reading that, I would like to show that one. I would like to show that one where I want to show. In access one, I want to show. To use access one, simply we need to write access of handles dot access one. We need to write like this. Handles means reference variable for access one. Access of handles dot access one. So now I want to show my input image. I am show of like what I am going to write some a equal to I am read. I have written. I am read of. I have written like so input image peppers dot png. I have written peppers dot png or something. I have written. So I want to show my input image a. So simply I am going to do that. See, I am show of a. So and then. And important thing you need to understand the function. This is a function. Push button one is a function. Push button is a function. Push button is a simply a function. Whatever the variables you write in this function, whatever the variables you write in this function will be only applicable for that particular function only. Will be applicable for that particular function only. That means the scope of a variable a. The scope of a variable a is limited to this function, not outside the function. But in push button 2, I want to convert this input image into something like black and white. In your mobile cameras, dial will take some image and crop and convert into black and white, enhance the intensity and enhance the color. Those different kinds of operations you do, right? So let us do that kind of things. So in push button 2, this variable b is not valid variable. B is undefined variable in push button 2. So in such case, we need to define this variable A as a global variable. We need to define this variable A as a global variable. Defining a global variable, what happens is most of the time some garbage values will be override. So let us take some reference variable. Handles dot. I'm taking some dummy variable or a buffer variable. OCO. Hope you people know what is a buffer variable. Buffer means a temporary variable. I'm going to take some temporary variable taking y is equal to a. That means I'm going to store my variable a. This is the variable a I want to use in other function also. But the scope of that variable is limited to this one. So that I'm going to store my a is in another variable y, buffer variable. So that I can use this variable y. That means handles. That means referencing to the front end GUI so that we can use anywhere in our this Y variable we can use anywhere in the program. So if I using A in another push button, that is an undefined variable because the scope is limited. So then once after ending of your function, once you are done with the function, we need to update the data, update the GUI data. To update the GUI data, simply you can write GUI data of handles dot h object. J data of handles dot h object. So that is a function we need to write that will be here. H object comma handles simply. H object comma handles. This is a GUI updation function. Please remember, this is a GUI updation function so that the entire code will be updated to our GUI now. So let us run the program or next push button also I want to write. So in this push button, I'm going to take my input image and I'm going to show. So in push button 2, I want to make that input image into black and white. So my image is now in variable y. From variable y, let us take a variable x. X equal to handles dot y. From a variable, from a buffer variable y, I'm going to take my original image into x. Y is a buffer variable here. Y is holding my input image. From y, I'm going to take my data into variable x. Now I want to convert into black and white. To convert into black and white, we have a function. Let us take some variable b and w. im2bw is a MATLAB function, input image processing toolbox function, which converts image into black and white. Let us convert im2bw of x. And I want to show it in access 2. Access of handles dot access 2. Handles dot access 2. And then I'm going to show. I'm sure of BW. I'm sure of BW. So this is a simple way. Access dot hand is dot two. I want to show my input image in access two now. So I'm sure of BW. Let us run the program. Let us run the program and how it goes. Let us see. So this kind of GUI will be open for you. Then click on input. Then input image will be displayed here. Click on output. Output image will be displayed. The input image is color image, and we are converting into black and white. In such a way, in image processing, we can use MATLAB. So hope you can understand. So if you have any questions, you can post your questions in chat box. I'm enabling chat box here. Now let me take some water. Let me take some break. So meanwhile, you can post your questions. Simply this GUI for loading an input image and converting into some black and white kind of things. You can post your questions. We can draw a picture by giving some hint codes. Yes. Yeah, specific for that I want to show. Chakravarti sir, I'll show. No, we cannot convert black and white images into color. But yes. So this is the input inbuilt image. No, we cannot do vice versa, because from black and white we cannot convert into color. Yes, we can do it for multiple images at a single time. Chaitanya Deepthi, yes. So let me show you how to load image. Yes, we can do any kind of manipulation on images. H object represent handles objects, handles or reference variable object. Yes, Hitesh, Mr. Hitesh Reddy, we can use it by creating executable file. Yes, we can give title to this one. How to give an image? Yes, let me show you that. Let me show you that. How to load image into this one. This in by default inbuilt image I have taken. If I want to load a particular image, if I want to load some particular image, how we can do that? Let me show you that. So push button one. So let us write some code for that. Let us take some F comma P, which indicates file name and path name equal to UI get file. UI get file is a function to get a file into MATLAB environment. So you can take any kind of file like JPG file, .jpg, .bmp, .tif, .png, different kinds of formats. What kind of image format you are going to take, that you can mention here in single quotes. So what I'm going to write here, let me explain you. I'm taking some two variables, f and p equal to ui get file, yeah, get file of, in single quotes, I'm writing some .jpg. So ui get file is a function to get a file into MATLAB environment from a browsing window. You can select any image or any file from your desktop and simply you can get it. Ui get file of .jpg I'm going to take. So the possible extensions are .bmp bitmap images, .png portable network graphic files, and .tif images, and .wav files, .mp4 files, and .txt files, .xlsx files, any files, many kind of files, any different kinds of files you can load into MATLAB. So once after executing this function, a browsing window will be opened. From that browsing window, select the appropriate image. Then after selecting, this function returns two strings. One is file name, other one is path name. One is file name, the other one is path name. So the file name holds the name of a file, path name holds the selected file path. So hope you people know, see here, this is a file name. On my screen, you can see my marker, my Z, something is that is a file name. The entire one is a path. So the path will be stored in P and file name will be stored in F. So let us write the code now. Now I want to add my file name with the path name to get the total path of my file. Strcat, string concatenation of string cat of P comma F. And then I want to read that image. So let us take some variable A equal to I am read of some X so that my input image will be read. So let us run this program and let us check. Let us run this program and that means these two lines to take a input image file from a particular path and storing that path in a variable X and then reading from that particular path. And again, the same operation. Let us run the program. So on clicking this input button, a browsing window will be opened. From the browsing window, you can select any image. You can select any image from the browsing window, or you can go for any part of your CPU. You can select any image. So you can select any kind of some image. I am going to select some different kinds of images. Simply I am select an image. Simply I have selected some image. Simply click on output. Then black and white image will be displayed. In such a way, we can load the files and we can get the outputs. You can load the files and you can get the outputs. That is very simple, right? I want to take some questions. If any questions, you can post. Chat box is enabled now with the host. You can talk to me now. Yes, we can take image through camera also. Yes, in 2009 also we have a feature, GUI. Yes, we can make some sounds also. How creating executable file is it a complex thing that takes hours together to understand? Yeah, we can apply some noise to this one. Yashwan, that is true. Yes, we can. We can take any input from web. Directly, if you have a URL, I am read of, simply can give URL. Shravanti, if I want to take data from website, web something, simply if you have a URL, then simply I am read of in single quotes, give that URL. Automatically that will be read. There are many types of images are there, so should we go to give more lines to programs or we can make some single program. Compression, yes, we can apply compression techniques, algorithms. Yeah, Shruti, we can extract the three planes, red, green, blue. Zoom out will not in this one also you can do, but in a figure window, if I show figure window, there will be option zoom. In a figure windows, there is an option do. Yeah, we can give video as input. Video files also can read. In video files, you can detect objects, you can detect face, we can track objects and videos also. Yeah, we can make choice for output or input, our choice that is. That is our choice, no problem. Yeah. So thanks for asking some valuable questions. We can use I am noise function. Let me show you that one also. Let us take. Yes. So I'm stopping chat box, disabling. So let me show you someone based on some questions. I would like to give you some more insights. First, suppose if I want to add some noise to my image, let me do that. Let me do that, some image noising. So let us write some variable, some n equal to, I'm going to take some n equal to, I am noise of my input image, that is x. I want to add some noise, some salt and pepper noise. I'm going to add some different toolbox functions that are available. Simply, I want to add some noise density, 0.03 or something. That's all. I want to show the output now. Let us show them n. And my input image is here, x. Let me show you the output of this one. You'll have some idea then. So let me share my screen. Click on input button and select some input image based on your interest. Let us take some input image. And click on output. The noisy image, you can see the image is now noised. Image is now added to noise. Noise is added to image. Hope you can see in my screen. Yes. So in such a way, you can simply perform some different kinds of operations. Hope you can understand now. So let me take some wave file, the sound. If I want to play some sound, how to read some wave file. That means some audio file. Let us take some audio file. So if I want to take an audio file, read of some x, and I want to play that one, wave play of some A, and I want to plot that one, plot of something. I want to plot that signal frequencies. Let us run the program first. Let me read some wave file and let me show you the output. So I need to select some wave file. Let me take some wave files. Let me check. Some wave files I have, dot wave. Some dot wave file I have. Let me check that dot wave file, where it is. So let me check, give me a moment. I'm checking my wave file, where I have that wave file. Wave file is not there. Let me check. Some wave file I have. Let me check that wave file so that we can use it. Yeah, or else simply we can download it from internet. Let me show you the same thing. Let me download from the internet the wave file. So let me share my screen. And I would like to download some wave file, that is a audio file. File download, let us download some wave files and do it. So instead of searching and wasting our time, let us do it. So sample wave files, I'm going to download some sample wave file. I'm downloading some wave file. So let us name it some other name. So let me share my screen. So let me share my GUI now. Let us run the program. So wave file I want to take input and then click on desktop. How's it my desktop? Where is my file? I couldn't see. Let me check my wave file first. Yeah, give me a moment, don't worry. Yes. So let me share screen now. Let us run the program. Click on input and click on the desktop. I have placed on my desktop. Here it is. I'm not getting. Sorry. Yes. Let me check with my downloads then. Dot wave files. Let us check for dot wave files. Dot wave files. So sorry, my desktop is behaving abnormally. Just give me a moment. No worries. Let me check. Meanwhile, you can take a break. So let me check with that. What happened with my desktop? Let me close it once, my GUI. It's behaving abnormally. Let me check once. So this is my code to simply read the wave file. I'm going to run my program and I'm going to share screen and then simply click on input and then so let us select the desktop. Where is the desktop? On my desktop I have the file. So simply I'll do one thing. Simply I'll do one thing. So in my MATLAB current folder itself, I place that so that everything will be clear. So this one is my wave file. Hope you can see my screen now. I'm going to show my screen. This is my wave file I have placed here. This is my wave file. So I'm going to rename it. Yeah. So I'm going to rename it some SVAT.SWAVE simply. I'm going to run my program. I'm going to run my program now. From the current folder itself, I want to read directly. I'm going to read my file here. So wave read off, I'm going to take as some SCAT.WAV. So click on run button and simply you can see I'm going to share my screen and click on run. And you can hear two sound. You can hear the sound. I hope you can hear the sound. Hope you can hear the sound. That means playing an audio file. Hope you can hear the sound. So can anyone check the green chat box? Can you people hear sound? Yes, after playing, it is showing some signal. It's showing some signal as well. Yeah. Yes. So let me show you again. Hope audio will be clear for you. The signal is now playing and that is plotted here. Such a way we can take some audio files also, we can load some videos also. For different things you can do. Yes. So in such a way we can access some audio files also. So to understand how to load the audio file and all, I have shown that one. Based on some requests from the users, I have shown that one. That's all. So let me share my screen. Let us continue the session. So in such a way, simply you can read wave read. For reading wave files, you can use wave read function, which is available in DSP toolbox, wave read to read wave files. To play wave play also we can use, as like we can take some videos and we can take some audio files as based on our interest. So in such a way simply you can do it. So let us simply move on to some, I would like to show some different applications of MATLAB and how we can design some different GUI applications and all. Let me show you some very good applications. Yeah, let me show you something. I would like to show some applications. Let me show you some very good applications of GUI. So I'm going to share. Please pay your attention. Will be very interesting. See here. See, you can see my screen now. I have created some GUI advanced simulation using MATLAB. Some project I have done. Simply let us click on start. Once you click on start, this kind of window will be open. That means in GUI, within GUI, we are creating another GUI as well. So this is the GUI for different kinds of noise. Different kinds of noises I'm going to add for single images. So let us click on browse button. Let us click on some browse button and select any image based on your interest. That is, select some image. And that selected image will be displayed here. If I want to add some different levels of noise, here you can see different levels of noises. You can see here some different levels of noises. You can see some different levels of noise. You can select any level of noise and then that level of noise will be added to your image and displayed here. Hope you can see. And then simply if I want to filter that one, this is also a real-time application, simply taking image and removing some noises and all. So let me show you how to reduce the noise from this image. Select a noisy image, select noisy image and click on mean filter and median filter. For two filters I have designed, mean filter and median filter. If you select a median filter, then output will be displayed here. By using median filter, the entire image is filtered. So this is input image, noisy image, filtered image. You can see here, I would like to explain you what I have done here. So this is my input image. This is my noisy image. This is my noisy image. And this is my filtered image. This is my filtered image. So on clicking this button, we can take some input image. Here, on clicking this one, level of noise, you can, we have placed some different levels of noise here. So different levels of noises, you can design some drop down buttons like this, pop-up menus, drop down buttons like this, you can do this like this. So, and you can select some different filters also, mean filter and median filter. Then it returns some mean square errors, PSNR values and based on the filters. Simply select another mean filter, then output will be change. You can see like this. You can design some interactive applications by using GUI like this. Hope it is clear for you. So in such a here also we can plot the histogram of a. We can plot the histogram of a image also. So in such a way these things will happen. And let me share one more good application. Let me share some one more good application. So just be on the line. Let me share some one or good applications. I'm going to share my screen. So one more good application, quality analysis, fruit quality analysis. I'm going to share with you the fruit quality analysis. I would like to show you some fruit quality analysis. So let me share the code and let me show you the output as well. So the main program is So let us run this program. This is a fruit quality analysis, how we can do this in real time. Simply select input image. I'm going to select input image and click on process and grading, fruit grading, automatically fruit grade. So it shows grade A. Simply it shows grade A. That means good quality fruit. This is a good quality fruit. Once you run the program, it shows the output. Performs different kinds of operations. And it shows you some different kinds of outputs. So input image and performing some different kinds of operations. Finally, it shows you grade of a fruit. So click on input image and give something, some other one input, and click on process. See here, grade D. That means the apple is damaged. The grade D you can see here on my screen. So in such a way, directly we can, without any human effort, simply by programming, we can do this, such kind of grade applications. And let us give some other one. Let us check what it is. This is grade C. A little bit damages are there, so that it is a grade C one. In such a way, we can use MATLAB for different kinds of maze processing and different kinds of signal processing and video processing, and biology also you can use. That we cannot find out. Mohan Krishna sir, we cannot find. How we can? So image means only even your human eyes cannot find, right? If you are not a robot, even we cannot find the internal damages. Even human intelligence also cannot find internal damages. Only the external damages only we can find. No, we cannot find internal damages. Yes. Yeah. So like this, and I would like to show some more applications. So let us process this. So let me show you some more good applications. Let me share my screen first. Closing all figures, close all. And I would like to show some more applications, good applications. Yeah, I would like to show the code also if needed. Simply you can go through it. Simply what I have done is taking input image, converting into HSV color space, based on intensities, I am going to grade it. Simply this is the code. This is the code which I have written simply for grading. So you can use it like this. And I would like to show some more good applications. Already I have shown you watermarking and quality analysis. And I would like to show one more thing, some like some more applications I would like to show. So meanwhile, you can post your questions if any you have. So let us run this program. Let me show. So let us design. Let me show you. This is a shadow lightning technique. For suppose if any image, serial image have a shadows, then objects will be not clearly visible. So to remove that shadow, to get the detail behind the shadow, we can use this kind of applications. Simply, these are the simply sliding bars, gamma correction, histogram equalization, log transformation, contrast stretching. These are some different kinds of techniques to enhance an image. These are some different techniques to enhance an image. So I'm going to simply, you can drag like this. You can drag like this. Then output, automatically outputs will be displayed here. We can drag like this and automatically outputs will be displayed. Automatically the values are going to be changes. You can see on my screen. Yes, like this we can do. We can design GUIs as well. And here also, I'm going to change. And here also I'm going to change. So in such a way, some different kinds of operations we can do. You can see while I'm changing the my slider, the values are going to be changes. Backend, we have written a code which are adaptable to this one. So such kind of things we can do with MATLAB. So different kinds of operations, shadow lightning techniques. Here, this is a good method then. So like this, we can do and we can create some different applications and we can get outputs. So let me show you one more good application, medical image processing application. Let me show you. For time being, I'm not explaining everything in detail. So it is 2 days only. So let me utilize the time to make you understand the importance and make you understand the good features of this MATLAB. That's my intention. And let me show you one more thing. Let me share the screen. So medical image processing, brain tumor detection kind of things, how we can do that. So let me show you that. So let me show you the brain tumor detection kind of things. Let me show you. So this is a code for brain tumor detection. Even experienced doctor can take up to 5 to 6 minutes. Yeah, we can save the outputs if needed. Yes, Shruti, you can do. And simply, so even experienced doctor take up to 6 to 5 minutes to find where is the tumor or the size of tumor or the severity of the tumor. But writing a code simply within fraction of seconds, 9 seconds or 10 seconds, simply you can get the output. Simply select an image or simply running the program, selecting an image and getting the output finally. So the final outcome, when you run the program, the final outcome is this one, finding the tumor itself. So this time taken for calculating and finding everything, the time taken is 8 seconds. Within 8 seconds, the tumor is detected and the tumor is marked and the area and the how many pixels and the severity also we can find. Within a fraction of seconds, we can do that one. Within a fraction of seconds, the how many pixels, that means how many pixels we have also we can detect. How many tumor pixels are there? Simply, this is a marking. We are going to mark this one. And we are going to find within fraction of seconds, that means within hardly 8 seconds it took. In such a way, simply we can have some different kinds of applications with this MATLAB. Right. Hope you can understand. I would like to show you the importance and the applications and the basic introduction and applications. Yesterday we are done with the introduction and today I'm going to I'm designed some application. I'm going to show some different kinds of applications as well. Let me show you some more good applications. Give me a moment. Or let me give you a moment. Yeah, CT, MR images we have used. So MR images. Give me a moment. I'm opening another one. So let us run some program for face recognition, face expression recognition. Let us check some face expression recognition. So let me show you that. Meanwhile, I'll take some questions. Meanwhile, I would like to take some questions. You can post your questions if you have. You can post your questions now, and I'll be happy to help you. Can you please show how video detection can be done? Yes. Yeah. So that you can talk with the college people. That is not my duty, not my cup of coffee. So let me share the command window. So Anita ma'am, please look into that. If you people, some people asking some soft copy of some sample codes, Anita ma'am, please look into that. If needed, I'll share with you, Anita ma'am, so that you can.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So let me show you something interesting. The facial expression recognition kind of things. Let me show you some facial expression recognition kind of things. Yeah, in mechanical system design, we can do with MATLAB. So what base is based on the thresholding, sir? Thresholding and the like entropy, based on the entropy that is done, sir. Let me show you some input image. Let me take some input image. Let us take some input image and let us run the program recognition. It may take some time. Please wait. Mathematical expression directly you can write, sir. I will show you that one in this session itself. Please wait for a moment. So the program is running. Please wait for a moment. It may take some time. The program is still running. The training the images and testing and different things. So this is done, and let me show you the output now. So in such a way, simply you can see this is matched with, this is the test image you have given in a database image. This is matched. So matched with the disgust, the facial expression recognition also we can do in such a way. Ranjita ma'am, that's true. It's true. Yeah, CDN images and MR images also we can fuse, and we can get the good details also. Even software also designed for these kind of things, some machines also. Some companies working on same. Yes, it is possible. You can take a CT scan image, MR image, and you can fuse it. You can get the detail even faster than the doctor. Yes, that is why automation is done. So this face recognition, simply you can see we have given a test image, this one, matched with the database image, this one, and facial expression, disgust. This kind of things will be, we can do. So in such an applications also we can do very different kinds of various areas of applications. Let me show someone asking me some differential equations and all mathematical things. So let me do that one. Let me share something like this. So SY system of equations, SYMS of X, and something I'm going to take. So let us write some F equal to 2X, F equal to something like, I'm going to write 2EX, 2X plus, or let us write something like 2X, let me write some 2X plus 4X square, or let us write some 4 into, let us, or else simply 2X square, let us write 2X square plus, 12 into X plus some 17 I have taken something. let us apply some differentiation for that diff of some function f. It returns output 4x plus 12. The output is 4x plus 12. Someone asking me a mathematical operation. Simply differentiation of this function also we can write. Simply differentiation. So let us write something. Int of 2x, 2 into x something if I write. 2 into x, it returns what? X square. Integration of 2x, that is x square. The mathematical things also you can do. Yeah. So integrations and differentiations also possible. Integrations and differentiations also possible. Hope you can see on my screen. Yes, in such a way integrations and differentiations also possible. Simply write a function and use a inbuilt function and we can get the outputs. Very simple. Linear algebraic equation solutions also we can get. Algebraic equations also we can simply can do it. So that's all from my side. You can take some question. You can ask some questions. Antapriya ma'am, I'm over to you. Meanwhile, I'll be here only. I'll take some questions if anything.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Dear participants, if you have any questions, please put your questions.
All the participants can post your questions. We'll be here. I'll be taking some questions and I'd like to explain you. So hope this session is very useful to you. Over to Anita ma'am. Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Dear participants, if you have any questions, just type your questions in the chat box. We are enabled the chat box.
Yes, ma'am. I have enabled chat box. Yeah. Latest version is 2020 MATLAB. So thank you all the participants and you can, if you have any requests, you can talk to Anita ma'am and you can post your questions to the ma'am also. Yes, a feedback link will be shared by college people. Anita ma'am, please look into that. People asking that.
Yes, sir. I will keep the feedback link at 12:50 p.m.
So directly you can download from MATLAB website trial versions or cracker versions also available. In machine learning also we can use MATLAB. Very good in interactive applications, inbuilt applications are there in MATLAB for machine learning. Dr. Raghavendra sir, that is for you, answer for you. So yeah, I would like to introduce skill to hire. View people from skill to hire. I would like to show you. So how you can access some different free courses or free courses and online classes and everything, I would like to show you. If you guys want to learn something new and advanced courses for free of cost and online live classes, simply you can visit. I am going to show you Skill to Hire. This is our website. There you can find many useful courses for you. This is the website. Here we have a live classes and courses. If you want, you can register with us and you can select the courses. What are the available courses? There are so many domains are there. See, machine learning libraries, C programming, big data, web development, pandas, C programming. Many others are available. Many courses for free of cost there are available. You can enroll and so many interview questions also, TCS interview questions, deep learning, and C++ interview questions, Python for IoT, Arduino, and all advanced technologies we have, and Google interview questions, Amazon interview questions, many Arduino interfacing, PICMA controller, and different interview companies interview questions, and data statistics for data science, and MATLAB for interview questions also are there. So many courses we have here, you can access many courses we have, and you can access for free. Simply click on that course and enroll now. These are the free courses. Simply click on enroll now, and then the course will be displayed for you, and you can learn for free, and certificate will be issued once after successful completion. So, and yes, Chakravarti sir, that is, yes, we do. And here we have different kinds of courses, and here simply click on introduction. Introduction also, we have some topics. Topics wise, simply click on that. Then that will be displayed for you. So you can complete the course and you can acquire the certificate. But suppose if you people need any projects also we have for a free of cost. So you can download some different kinds of projects in different domains. So web development and as well cyber security and as well image processing, MATLAB, many are. Yeah, so many are there here. So this is the way we can access, and you can someone faculty members, you can be become a mentor, and live classes here. You can see live classes, what are ongoing my live classes. And I would like to conclude this session by recap all the topics what we have covered. From the basics to application development, we have discussed. From the basics, what MATLAB is and what MATLAB window look like, and basic mathematics with the MATLAB, and the command window, editor window, and command history, and workspace window, and how to create a matrix, how to access the matrix values, and simply how to generate a signal, how to plot the data, how to customize the data, how to plot the customized data, and everything we have discussed. And today's session, we have discussed about how to create some good application with the GUI and mathematical applications we can do, and as well image processing and signal processing, audio reading, many things we have discussed, all these topics we have discussed. So simply click on the someone asking me how to become a mentor. Simply click on a become mentor. You need to give your details, then access will be given to you. So we have discussed all those topics from basics to applications, I have shown. Thank you so much. Thank you, one and all. Over to Anita, ma'am. Yeah.
Sir. Sir, can you please stop sharing, sir? Then I can keep the.
Sure. Yes, ma'am. Yes, I do.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Dear participants, if you have any queries, please keep the queries in chat box. I request all the participants, if you have any queries, keep the queries. Regarding the certificates and everything, we will send within 3 working days.
Do you hear me?
Good afternoon to one and all. Thanks for attending this 2-day national level workshop. That is introduction to MATLAB and its applications. This is the time to vote of thanks on behalf of Sri Venkateshwara College of Engineering, myself, GM Anita Priyadarshini, head of the Department of Electronics and Communications. Now I would like to thank to our management in their absence. And also I would like to thank to our principal sir and Kishore sir and vice principal of Chakravarti sir. Thank you very much for your support for conducting this workshop in a successful manner. And also I thankful to our resource person, Satya Kumar sir and Subrayadi sir. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity for conducting this MATLAB and its application in our college. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you for your patience for clarifying all the doubts of our participants. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. And also thanks to all the participants for attending this workshop. I think this workshop is very useful for you, especially for the students, those who are going to learn this image processing and signal processing in their curriculum. And also thanks to all the faculty members, those who are joined in this workshop. I'm very thankful to all the faculty members. Thank you so much. And also, and thanks to all the faculty members and also the teaching and non-teaching staff and all the entire the Department of Electronics and Communications of Sri Venkateshwara College of Engineering. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you on behalf of the EC department. And also I'm very much once again thankful to the Satyakumar sir for giving this wonderful sessions for the 2 days. Thank you so much, sir. And now I'm going to keep the feedback link. This feedback link will be live only for the 15 minutes. Please fill the feedback and send to us. And also thanks to so much. Thank you for all the organizers for this. For thank you so much once again. And we are sending the certificate within the 3 days of your registered email ID while you are filling this application form. Thank you so much. Now I'm putting the feedback link. Just fill the feedback link and send it. Now I want to tell one more thing. I'm happy to inform to that Sri Venkateshwara College of Engineering is going to organizing one more FDP that is organized by the Computer Science and Engineering. So that is, we are already going to kept in this groups. So those who are interested, it is very useful for the faculty members and the students. So this is the machine learning and deep learning using Python. On 12th June, the FDP dates for 12th June to 16th June. The resource person is Gaurav Kumar, so from Haryana. And this is very useful for the students and also for the faculty members and for the students, especially it is useful for you for doing the projects and internships. It is very useful. Application form and everything in the WhatsApp group. Try to utilize this. The FDP name is Machine Learning and Deep Learning using Python. Now I kept the feedback link and also fill the feedback and submit the feedback link. Thank you so much. Over to Satyakumar sir. Now I request any one of the participants to give our feedback. You can turn off your microphone and give the feedback. Now I request all the participants.
इसीलिए
Now I will send again one more feedback link. It will take some time, or otherwise I will keep in all the WhatsApp group. Try to cooperate with us. We will send the feedback link. I'm going to send one more feedback link. It will take 5 minutes time. Please try to cooperate, everyone. Or otherwise I will keep the feedback link in WhatsApp group. You can submit. Sir Satya Kumar sir, hello. Now I kept the new feedback link. All the participants, please fill the feedback link. I kept the new feedback link. All of you, submit the feedback link. Now I request the any one of the faculty members or the student to speak about a few words about the workshop. We kept the new mail ID, a new feedback link. I kept the new mail ID for the feedback. All of you fill the feedback. I request any one of the participants to speak few words about the 2 days workshop. Ranjit Kumar sir, I unmute you. Ranjit Kumar sir. Ranjit Kumar sir. Ranjit Kumar sir. Ranjit Kumar sir.
Ranjit
Kumar sir.
Ranjit Kumar sir.